Once you fired your case, or you have some fired cases that you've procured, you'll notice that sometimes the condition varies. If it's only been fired out of your rifle and you took a brand new case, fired it out of your rifle and then extracted it, you got home from the range and you're looking at your cases, they probably look pretty clean still. There may be some slight discoloration or some slight carbon on the outside of the case, but they may seem pretty clean. Or you may have got some cases from somebody, or you fired cases successfully without cleaning them, and they can be quite dirty. Cases fired out of semi-automatic platforms tend to be dirtier than cases fired out of bolt rifles, because you have gas that's moving around the case and things like that. So cleaning a case, removing that carbon buildup, removing those contaminants, the dirt, the things that you don't want to go up into your sizing die, cleaning you could do a couple of different ways. If you feel that you need to, you can take fired cases with the primer still in and clean them. The best method for cleaning them is using something like Frankfurt Arsenal's rotary tumbler, like using stainless steel pins. The advantage of a system like that is the stainless steel pins do a great job removing any contaminants, any sort of dirt that's on the case, and they're easily removed. You just simply dump the case out and the pins fall out. When I first started doing this stuff, we had these old tumblers, vibratory tumblers that used like media, like made out of corn cob or walnut shell, and they can actually get stuck in the primer pocket hole. That happened to me once at a very high level national championship event, and I had numerous rounds that failed to fire. And I didn't know what happened. When I got home and I extracted the primer, I realized that I unloaded the cartridges, that I had media that was stuck in the primer pocket. So one advantage of like a stainless steel pin system is you don't really have that problem. But a sort of a normal process would be, you take your cases, your fired cases. We talked about why we size them and how you size them. You apply a lubricant to that case so that it goes in and out of the sizing die without getting stuck. Remember, you have metal to metal contact there. So just like when the cartridge cases are made in the factory, they use lubricant. They clean that lubricant off before they put them in the box and send them to you, a LaPo case. You're also applying a lubricant to that case so it can be run in and out of that die so it doesn't stick in the die. That lubricant needs to be removed before you fire the case. So you'll size the case, which also has a pin in it that knocks the old primer out. And you'll look at it. And after you size that case, inside the primer pocket, you'll notice that it looks like black or dark, or may even be some crusty bits like carbon in there. That's residue from the primer firing, the ignition of the primer. So you put that case in a tumbler and follow the directions on how long to do it and how many cases to put in, etc., and tumble it. When you remove those cases, they'll be clean. The outside of the case will be clean, the inside of the case will be clean, and in some cases the primer pockets will be clean. And when you tumble these cases and when you clean them, you really want to make sure that you're going to only add the cleaning solution to these stainless steel pins, which is really recommended and authorized by the manufacturer. There's lots of homebrew. People use things like Pledge Lemon Shine and all these other things that kind of like homemade recipes to clean a case. I would recommend only using the cleaning solutions provided by the manufacturer, because some of these home kind of brew remedies, they actually have too much acid in them and you may degrade the composition of your case. You could pull essential elements out of the case like zinc, which will make it perform not as well, and in extreme situations maybe make the case fail. So you don't want to do that. So use the approved solutions to apply to the media when you're tumbling those cases. So after the case is clean, sometimes you need an additional step of cleaning that primer pocket, getting the black carbon out of the case, out of the primer pocket. So the Trim and Prep Center, the Frankfurt Arsenal Trim and Prep Center, they have a tool that you can use to insert. It rotates. You just put the cartridge case, the primer pocket onto that tool, and it just scrapes out all the carbon. And that's all I ever do. Some people do like to put a cutting tool inside the primer pocket to uniform them, but I found with Lapua cases that's really not required. You just can clean out the case to where the carbon is gone, and your primer is going to go back in there with a nice tight fit, and you're ready for your next firing.